Okay, so now that we know why you add fractions the way you do, let's go ahead and practice adding together two fractions with larger denominators. So for example, let's say we wanted to add, how about 5 over 18, and to that we want to add, let's say, 3 over 20. Okay, so these fractions have pretty large denominators, right? And it's impractical for us to take a pizza and divide it into 18 pieces, and a second pizza and divide it into 20 pieces, and then subdivide those pizzas to get a common denominator, like we did earlier. So the question is, how can you find a common denominator so you can add these two fractions together? So the way we do that is we take the denominators and write them off to the side. So over here I'm going to write first 18, and then right next door I'm going to write 20. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to find the prime, what's called the prime factorization of each number. And the way you do that is by starting off with any factorization you can think of the numbers, of each number individually. For example, I can see that 18 is 2 times 9. Now, somebody else could start with 3 times 6, and it turns out that where you start is not going to affect your end result. So 2 times 9 is fine. 2 is prime, and 9 can be written as 3 times 3. At this stage, I can see that the 2 and the 3, and the other, well, 2 and 3 are prime numbers, so 18 has been written as a product of prime numbers. Let's do the same thing for 20. 20, for example, can be written as 4 times 5. And, well, 5 is prime, but 4 is not. 4 can be written as 2 times 2. And then 5, of course, is prime. Notice how, at this stage, 5 was prime and 4 wasn't. I still carried 5 down, though. And the reason I do that is because I like to have all my primes on a single line. It just makes the next step easier. So at this stage, I've written 18 as a product of primes, and I've written 20 as a product of primes. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to build up what's called the LCD. And LCD stands for least common denominator. And what it is the smallest number that both 18 and 20 go into evenly. So here's how you do it. And I'll create another video explaining why this is the case. But for right now, let me just show you how we do it. Okay, so what we do is we look at 18's factorization and we compare it with 20's factorization. So I first think about the 2's and I say, oh, okay, 18 has 1 2 and 20 has 2 2's. And then I ask myself, which number has more 2's? Which factorization has more 2's? And clearly, 20's factorization has more 2's. What I then do is I write down 20's number of 2's. In this case, I write down just 2 2's. So it's very important at this stage to realize that simply because you see 1, 2, 3 2's, you don't write them all down here. You just do a comparison of the two factorizations and ask yourself which one has the most of that number and then choose the most to write down here. So for example, you know, if there was 1, 2 here and, you know, 4 2's over here, I'd write down 4 2's. I wouldn't write down all the 2's that I see everywhere. Let's go on to the 3's. 18 has, let's see, 2 3's, and 20 has no 3's. So I write down 2 3's. And now I'm going to do the same thing for the 5's. And looking at the 5's, I can see that, well, 20 has 1 5, and 18 has no 5's, so I put in that 1 5. Okay, now when you multiply all these numbers together, 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 5, what you get, that number is the LCD. So let's see, 2 times 2 is 4, times 5 is 20, and then times 9 is 180. So that's my LCD. What we then do is we take that LCD, and what we're going to do is we're going to write these fractions with that denominator 180. So this fraction, instead of being 5 over 18, it's going to turn into something over 180. And the same thing for the second fraction. Instead of being 3 over 20, it's going to be something over 180, and the somethings here are to be determined now. Okay, so there are two ways to do this. First of all, I can just see that 18 times 10 will give 180. So there's nothing wrong with that observation, but it turns out that there's something over here, there's another way of getting that 10 that will be useful for us when we're working with adding together rational expressions. And so here's another way of doing that. What we're trying to do is we're trying to convert 18 into 180. Okay? Now 18 is over here. It's 2 times 3 times 3. And that 18 is trying to become the 180, but 180 is all of this, right? 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 5. So if you compare what 18 has, if you compare that with what the 180 has, do you see what's missing when you compare these? Let's see. 2 threes, 2 threes. 1 2, oh, 2 twos. So this is missing a 2. And it's also missing what? Well, it's also missing a 5. So do you see that this has a 2 and 2 threes, and this has a 2 and 2 threes, but this also has a 2 and a 5 that this doesn't have. What's the meaning of that? What that means is that if I take this, which is 18, remember, and I multiply it by a 2 and a 5, I'll get this. That is, if I take 18 and I multiply it by 2 times 5, I'll get 180. And of course, 2 times 5 is 10, and that tells me that this times 10 will give me this. And that's how I know over here that 18 times 10 will give me 180. I just viewed it in factored form. Okay, so now we'll take the 18 and we'll multiply it by 10. But then, of course, we multiply the numerator by 10 as well. And 5 times 10 is 50. Let's do the same thing for the next fraction. So the 20 is trying to become 180, right? Okay, so here's 20. And here's the factored form of 20. And this factored form of 20 is trying to become the factored form of 180. Do you see what's missing? Well, here I have a 2, a 2, and a 5, and here I have that, but I also have more. What's missing is the 9. So this needs a 3 and a 3, right? So if I put a 3 and a 3 right here, or, you know, if I multiply this by a 3 and a 3, I'll get the LCD, which means that 20 times 9 will give me 180. And that's why over here I say, okay, 20 times 9, 3 times 9, and then 3 times 9 is 27. Now we're in a good situation, right? Because I'm adding together two fractions with the same denominator, and so I can add the numerators, and I get 77 over 180. Now at this stage, sometimes you can reduce this fraction. It turns out that 180, you know, 180 is a big number, but remember, 180 is just 2s, 3s, and 5s. So if there's going to be any simplification, any cancellation, well, that means there'd have to be a 2, a 3, and a 5 occurring in the numerator. And there's not, right? Because 77 is only 7 times 11. So if this is only 7 times 11, and the 180 is only 2s, 3s, and 5s, there's not going to be any cancellation. And so 77 over 180 is our sum. And that's how you add two fractions with more complicated denominators.